Hi friends, in Angular 16, an exciting new feature has been introduced, signals. Signals are reactive primitives that offers granular tracking of state changes within the application. Signals was introduced in Angular 16 and became stable in Angular 17. In this video, I'm going to explain some of the key concepts in signals, benefits of using signals, and then I'm going to show you how to implement signals in an Angular application. Before that, I request you to subscribe to this channel and support me. Okay, let's start. To understand about signals, we need to know about three reactive primitives: writable signals, computed signals, and effects. Writable signals are a specific type of signal in Angular that allow you to modify their value directly. Let me explain this using an example. I have created this simple application in which I have a button and a count value. On clicking this button, this count value will increase. For that, I have created a count variable, and on clicking this button, I'm calling a function, and inside this function, I'm just increasing this value. Now let's change this to a writable signal. How can we change this? We just need to use the signal constructor. We can also pass the initial value like this. Now this is a signal, and so we cannot directly increment it. It will throw error. If I console log this, we can see this is a signal function. So how can we access the value? We just need to call the function. Now we can see the value. And so you can ask me to fix this, can we do like this? No, we cannot assign a value to a signal like this. There are few inbuilt functions available to change the value of a signal. If you need to just replace the value, we can use the set function. Let me set the value as 7. Now if I click the button, we can see it is getting changed to 7. Similarly, instead of 7, if I give this dot count plus 1, we can see this is getting incremented. But according to Angular documentation, we have to use set to update a simple value. And we can use update method to update a new value of a signal depends on its previous value. So let me use the update method. Update method accepts a function like this. We can see this is working as expected. So we have seen how we can update simple values like number. Let me show you how we can update an array. Let me create a new signal having an array as initial value. Initially, I have kept two elements in the array. Now I need to add another element. For this use case, we have another method, mutate. Mutate accepts a function which takes all the values as parameter, and we can use the push method to add the value and return all values like this. Now if I put a console log, we can see when I click the button, we can see the new value has been added in the array. But this will work only in Angular 16. This has been dropped in Angular 17. Instead of mutate, we can use update itself. But when we use update function, instead of push, we need to use the spread operator, like this. We can see this is working. So we have learnt about writable signals. Let's move to computed signals. Computed signals are essentially values derived from other signals. Computed signals are read-only. We cannot directly set the values of computed signals. Let me show you an example. Let me create a new signal, length, and another signal, breadth. Now let me create a computed signal, area, which is going to be the product of both. Let me show this area instead of count. We can see 800. Now when I click the button, let me update one of the signals, maybe length to 30. Now if I click the button, we can see 1200. That means when one of the signals is changed, the computed signal is automatically getting recalculated. That is about computed signals. We have one more concept, effects. Signals are useful because they can notify interested consumers when they change. And an effect is an operation that runs whenever one or more signal values change. Effects always run at least once. Like computed signals, effects keep track of their dependencies dynamically. Let me show you how to create an effect. The good place to create an effect is inside a constructor, because effect function requires an injection context. So inside constructor, let me create an effect. Effect accepts a function. Inside that function, let me put a console log. Inside the console log, let me use the count signal. Similarly, let me create another effect. Now let me use the color signal. First, let me update only the count signal. Now if I click the button, we can see only the first effect is triggered. Let me comment this and update the color signal. Now we can see the second effect is getting triggered. If I update both, we can see both the effects will be triggered. If I just refresh the browser, we can see these, because effects always run at least once. Effects will be used in many places. For example, if you want to log something when a signal is changed, we can use effects. If you need to update the local storage when a signal is changed, we can use effects. But there are certain things we need to consider while using effects. We should not update any signals inside effects, because it may trigger infinite circular updates and trigger unnecessary change reduction cycles. To avoid this, setting signals is disallowed by default in effects, but we can enable that if it is really necessary. I will show you an use case shortly to enable setting signals inside effects. Okay, we have learned the important concepts in signals, but do you understand why we really need to use signals? Let me explain that also using a simple example. Let me create a variable a equals to 10 and another variable b equals to 20. Now let me create another variable c, which is equal to a plus b. And in ng-onInit, let me console log this c. After that, let me change the value of a to 50. Now let me console log this c again. And so we can see 30 and 30. This is because the value of c was calculated before the value of a was changed. And so c has no idea whether the value of a has been changed or not. There is no reactivity. Let me implement the same using signals. Okay, now we can see the first console log is printing 30 and the second one is printing 70, because now the signal c has been notified that one of the dependent signals has been changed. And so the value has been recalculated. This has reactivity. Hope you understood the use of signals. Now let's see how signals are useful in a real-time application. I have created this add to cart application. Here we can add fruits and vegetables to the cart. And we can click this cart to see the items in the cart. Also, I have implemented a mechanism to show the points to be earned based on the cart value. I have added only limited features. For example, I have added logic only to add to cart. There is no feature implemented to reduce the quantities or to remove the item from cart. The reason is, I want you to focus on the signals implementation. Adding too many features may deviate us from the concept. Also, I have not implemented a perfect add to cart design. For example, I have added some subjects, some at input and at output, etc. Definitely, we can follow a better design to avoid this. But I have implemented this in such a way that I can explain you the signals concept. Okay. First, let me show you this feature. When we click this cart is getting opened, and on clicking this close button, we can close this cart. Let me explain how I have implemented this. In cart service, I have created a behavior subject which is having an initial value as false. In header component, on clicking this cart icon, I am calling a function. Inside that, I am changing the value of the subject to true. Similarly, in the cart component, on clicking this close button, I am changing the value to false. And in app component, I have injected the cart service, and in the template, I have kept the cart. And I am toggling a class named open based on the behavior subject value. I have used the async pipe to resolve the subject. And in CSS, you can see I have placed the cart in fixed position away from the viewport, and when the class is added, I am moving the cart inside the viewport. I have also used a transition effect. Okay, now let's see how we can use signals to simplify this. First, in the cart service, I don't want the behavior subject. Instead, let me create a signal. Let me keep the initial value as false. In the header component, let me remove this and let me set the signal value as true. Similarly, let me set it as false in the cart component. Finally, in the app component, I don't want the async pipe. I can simply get the value of the signal. That's it. We can see it is working like before, but now we don't need the behavior subject to notify all the components. Okay, in the cart service, we can see I have two more subjects. The refresh cart subject is to notify the cart component whenever I add an item to cart, so that the cart will be refreshed. You can see in add item component, once an item is added to cart, I am calling the next function of this subject. And in the cart component, ngOnInit, I am subscribing to this subject. And whenever there is a new value, I am calling the refresh cart function. In this refresh cart function only, I am having the logic to calculate total price, total quantities, and the final cart to display in the cart pop-up. You can see, if the item is already in the cart, I am just increasing the quantity, or otherwise, I am adding the item into the cart. Also, I am maintaining the total value of the cart in the cart service, so that I can use that to calculate the points. So, after the value is set in the cart service, I am triggering another subject, refresh header. In the header component, I have subscribed to this refresh header subject, and whenever a new value is received, I am calling the refresh points function. In this function, I have the logic to calculate the points. Now let's see how we can change this implementation and use signals. So in cart service, let me delete these two subjects. I don't want them because I am going to use signals. And let me change this cart and this total value to signals. In add item component, we don't want to notify now, so let me remove that. And in the cart component, we don't want to subscribe. Let me remove that also. Similarly, in the cart component, we don't want to notify. And so let me remove this line. And in the header component, we don't want to subscribe to the subject. Let me remove that as well. As we have changed this cart and total value to signals, in the cart component, we need to change this. Now we are getting an error. This is because of TypeScript. We can fix this by adding a type in the signal declaration in the cart service. And then here we need to use the set function to set the value. Okay, in the header component, we don't need this function. Instead, let's create this points as a computed signal, so that whenever the total value signal is changed, this will be automatically recalculated. And when we change this to a signal, we need to change the template as well. This cart is also a signal now, and so we need to change this as well. To add an item into an array, we can use the mutate function. Like this. Okay, let's test this. When I add some items to cart, we can see the cart count is getting changed. But if I open the cart, we cannot see any items. Also, this points is not getting updated. What could be the reason? The problem is in the cart component. Earlier, we used the subject to trigger this refresh cart function. But now, this is not at all called. So how can we trigger this function? Here comes the use of effects. Let me create an effect inside the constructor and let me call this function. That means, whenever my cart signal is changed, I need to call this refresh cart function. But if I refresh this page, we can see an error. We cannot set a signal value inside an effect or inside computed signal. We can see we are setting the total value signal here. This is not allowed. But we know this is not going to trigger any infinite change reduction cycles or impact anything. So for this scenario, we can use the create effect options, where we can set allow signal writes to true, like this. Let's test this once. It is working as expected. Hope you understood how we can make use of signals in our applications. If you like this video, please hit the like button, subscribe to this channel, and share this video with your friends and colleagues. Post your valuable comments in the comment section. I'll be back with another interesting concept soon. Thank you. Bye.